I'm here with Lisa Donovan, our incredibly talented pastry chef at Husk, and today we're going to make little hand pies with some of this fantastic fruit preserves.
We have strawberry rhubarb and we have peach. We just got our first peaches of the season.
So what's great about this is you take something at its peak, something that's perfect. You capture that essence in this.
Right.
I think why a lot of people have a bad idea of preserved food is because a lot of the preserved food is just made with whatever.
Like they take a really good peach and they just drown it in sugar. And then all you have is sugar and a couple of peaches in a jar and it destroys the peach.
Yeah, and you don't get that flavor.
Yeah.
So your technique is super, super low, 5 to 7 hours.
Yeah, kind of low and slow. I don't like to add a lot of sugar. So I let them go sometimes for a couple of days. I just keep putting it back on the stove and let it pull its own sugar out.
Smells like the fruit cup from elementary school.
Perfect. That's completely what I was aiming for.
It does. That's a fantastic smell.
So we're going to move on to the pie crust. And don't be scared.
Thank God for you, because the pies would be terrible here if I made them.
It's just about keeping things cold, man. That's it.
Don't make it sound so easy. I've tried to make pie crust a million times.
Okay, there is one thing. People chop up their butter too small. See how big that chunk is? Like, put some big chunks of butter in there and just smear butter into flour. That's what you're looking for. You're looking for little buttery, floury leaves. And if that butter is cold when it's mixed into your flour, what it's going to do is it's going to do this really beautiful, almost like a puff pastry striation of, of layers. And it's just...
That's the first thing I noticed about your pie crust. It was almost like puff pastry.
Yeah.
It was just like layers.
Really, like, I can't stress enough. It's less about this and more about cold and giving it extreme temperatures.
So what are your ratios of water to flour to butter?
Quite honestly, like butter to flour, it's about 2 to 1. With the water, I just add a little, and I go, doesn't take a whole lot with as much butter as in here.
That was like hardly any water.
That was hardly any water. It's mostly butter.
Well, that's where I'd screw it up.
And so if you did it right, you should see some pretty little baby flakes of butter in there.
Beautiful.
So that's it, and then you just wrap it up and put it in the fridge. And you just let it chill for at least 30 minutes, and then you can pull it out and fill it with whatever you want. And so we're gonna do hand pies.
So why do you think pies are such an important part of Southern culture?
I tell you what, nothing makes people happier than pie. I don't know what it is, I have no idea.
Everybody loves
pie. You bring someone a pie, done.
Like especially if it's a totally badass
pie. You are invited to all of their weddings, baby showers, forever and ever and ever. Just want a little egg wash to seal it up. So we'll do a peach. Pretty
it's like condensed peach.
Yeah. All right, I'm just gonna seal her up.
And a quick little glaze. How worried should you be about air in there?
Not so worried, because you always just come at it like this.
Yep. And that's gonna let that steam from the fruit and the dough.
Mm-hmm. And I just do a little sugar. And that's it. And then let it hang out, get cold again. And then we'll stick it in the oven. Put them in there nice and cold at 375 for about 15 minutes.
You can get rich off these things, Lisa.
I'm gonna try.
Is it hot?
So hot. Can you handle it?
Ah! I can handle it.
All right, cheers, man.
Cheers. I got peach. Oh! It's so hot! It's so worth it, though. Mmm.
Yeah?
Doesn't get any better.
I love it when you shake your head.